We're live. Hello, everybody. Welcome along to the live stream. For those that don't know me and you're watching this live, hello, I'm Gavin Hoey. And if you don't know me and you're watching the recorded version, hello, I'm Gavin Hoey. I don't know why I said that. That's kind of weird, isn't it? But that's the joy of live. We're going to be live for the next 45 minutes on my channel. I think we've got some people watching. I think we have. This is kind of good. I'm not on my own, though, just in case you're worrying that I'm doing this all on my own. I've got a couple of people helping me. You can see them and you can hear them, because behind the camera, I've got Freya on the super switcher and Sam on the comments.
Hey, everyone. How's everyone doing? Lots of answers, please. we've got lots of people with us. Would you like to know where they're
yes,
from?
Yes, sorry, I just hadn't realised I was going to be on screen. I thought I'd just wander off.
Yeah, you come back. So we've got Czech Republic.
The whole of it?
The whole of Czech Republic.
Wow,
yeah,
marvellous.
We've got Nevada, Denmark, and I'm going to say hi to Alan, because I always miss you, from Bushy Park. Hi, Alan.
Hey, Alan from Britain.
Yeah, we've got Germany, Switzerland, Texas, Canada, Kuwait, Philippines, everyone.
Everybody that's important is here. Well, thank you very much for joining me live. Thank you for joining me if you're watching the recording. If you're watching the recording, say hello in the comments. Appreciate all the live people saying hello. And of course, hit the like button, because it really does help. The sooner you hit it, the more people actually might come and find us. Although, having said that, do we really want anyone to find this live stream? I don't know. So, little backstory. On Friday, I'm going up to Birmingham in the UK, and Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, I will be at the photography show, which is the UK's biggest photo video event. I'm going to be on the Godox essential photo stand doing two demos a day. One's going to be flash. Haven't quite worked that one out. That's going to be tomorrow's job. And the other demo every day is going to be LED lighting. And that's what I'm going to do today. I'm going to try and see whether any of my ideas actually makes sense when I do them out loud. Because if you've ever done any demos, if you've ever been asked to demo anything at any time, not necessarily photography related, you can have the best ideas in the world, but it's not until you vocalize them that you suddenly discover just how good or not they are. So I'm going to talk you through some ideas. This isn't my demo. I'm not expecting this to be any good. I did say in the description it might be a little bit kind of rough and ready, and I think that's a fair description. On the floor, you'll notice there's a kind of a gap here. I think, and I don't know for sure, I think this is about as much room as I have on the stand. You never get much room on stands. This is about 2 and a bit meters. It's not absolutely set in stone. You can sort of step back into the audience if you warn people, but I'm going to try and stay mostly kind of in this area, but I'm not going to be too rigid about it because I don't actually know. But if I can make it fit that area, I will. Sam is waving her hand.
I'm waving my hand.
They can't see you waving your hand, but she's waving.
So Stephen said, hi Gavin, sorry I'll miss you this year at the photo show. Being in hospital, so recovering, so have a good one. So
oh,
I hope
Stephen.
You feel better soon, Stephen.
Yeah, absolutely.
They do a few live streams, I think, from the show.
Don't think I'm being live streamed on anything. But
it's not just you there.
No.
Sadly, for you.
I presume as he's put it in, he might be interested in actually seeing me at the show. But you're right, I shouldn't make such assumptions.
And also, Joe asked, is Gavin coming to Michigan for ClickCon?
Not as far as I know, but never say never. I'm open to suggestions, and if the organisers are interested and can make it happen, then terrific. Okay, so let's talk about kits. What am I going to be using? So, camera-wise, not really, it's any camera will do. And that's actually quite true with LEDs, because with LED lighting, last time we did this at a trade show, more people took pictures with their cell phones than they did with their actual cameras, because more people have a cell phone with them. And with LED lighting, the results were pretty good actually. So I'm not gonna worry too much about the camera. I'm using an OM system if you really want to know. It's the lighting. This is a Godox SZ150R. So I'm doing stuff for Godox, that's the brand I'm representing, and I asked for an RGB light. So this is an RGB cob light, which normally if you get an RGB one, it's a panel or a tube. So this one's a little bit different, but we'll have a look at its pros and cons in a minute, because there are a few. So I think my idea is I'm gonna start by just setting it up as a kind of, you've bought yourself one of these lights, it will do. And just so you're wondering, yes, this is extremely bright. I don't know how bright it's going to be at the NEC. I can't really gauge the room exposure. With LED lights, you're always working with the ambient light, With flash, you can remove it, but with LED, you have to take it into account. So I'm going to assume it's at this level of brightness, and if it's any darker, I'll be happy. Hence, it's pretty bright. Hence, my amazing Polly, who's my model for today, is wearing sunglasses. Because, you know, she's a little photophobic. So, yeah, you can use it as just a standard light. Let's just get a picture on the screen. Let's just reset all this, because you don't want to see that. You want to see this, and you want to see that. There we go. Okay, so, I like to work in manual mode. Whenever I'm doing anything with portraits, I've just found manual mode to be the best with these sorts of lights, because the lighting isn't changing enough for me to warrant being on something like aperture priority or shutter priority. So manual is where I'm going to be. I've got the little histogram up in the corner of my screen. And of course, being a mirrorless camera, what I see is more or less what I'm going to get. There we are. I think, can we stop there? Oh, I should say what Chloe is wearing. Chloe, is Polly is wearing is what Chloe's going to wear. Reverse that sentence. What Polly is wearing today is what Chloe, who is going to be my model, is going to be wearing. Yeah, not the other way around, otherwise she'd be wearing a woolly hat, wouldn't she? That's what Polly normally wears. So, hence this shiny thing. And it's shiny not because it looks cool, it's because I want as much light to bounce around as I can and show light, even if it's not necessarily as bright as I would like. So there is a logic to it.
But it is also cool.
It is also cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, so just like anything else, I'm going to hopefully show you the fact that you can just move your lights around and your model can turn into the lights. And to be fair, I won't be picking Chloe up by the neck and turning around either, just in case anyone's won, you know, it's kind of like, that's not how you interact with your models. I mean, it's not recommended anyway. anyway, there we go. So something like that. Same distance, same exposure, don't have to change too much. And I'm probably going to get a reflector because, you know, you can. Here we go, have a little reflector. At this point, I will definitely get someone from the audience to hold this because, it's just not easy to do. Not easy to do. Oh my goodness. So yeah, I'm definitely going to get someone from the audience to hold this. Sound effects are not going to be included in the final version. Okay, there you go. And what the lovely thing about LED is what you see is what you get. So, that works. I'm going to do that. That's great. There we are. I should have done that before. Yeah, another reason I'll get someone else to do it is it's safer. Okay, so, you know, you can move the reflector around. What you see is what you get. I like LEDs. I'm really growing towards LEDs quite a lot just recently. So that's that. Oh, I should say, this is live. If you're watching the live, you are allowed to ask questions. You may not get an answer, but you are allowed to ask questions. If you're watching the recorded version, you can ask questions. I try and get around to them as often as I can. All right, okay, pretty basic stuff. Let's do something a bit more exciting. Let's just pop a light in a fairly safe, sensible place. I don't have a lot of room. I mean, I moan about the studio being small. When you go and do a trade show demo, an expo demo, you realize your studio is quite big. All right, I'm gonna have another light. I have multiple lights.
So yeah. Joe asked, what's the power of the LED?
That is a really good question, Joe. It is the SZ150R. So let me kind of break that down a little bit. Actually, I don't know what the S stands for, but the Z is zoom. It has a zooming head, which does absolutely nothing as far as I can see. It's supposed to allow you to focus the light. Just buy the one without the Z. Probably shouldn't say that, but just there's a one without the Z, probably L. Just get that one, it's much better. So it's got a zoomable head. 150 is 150 watts, but what you'll see in a minute is when I change this to its R, which is the Arbit GB, there is a bit of an issue, something to be aware of. So 150 watts is its maximum potential power. Let's leave it at that.
A question here from Brian. Do you ever use a light meter when using LED lights?
Not really, Brian, no. I mean, you could. There's no reason at all why you couldn't. You know, I can get... Actually, I don't even know where my light meter is, Brian. That is a good question. Oh, here it is. Here we go. One light meter. Let's just turn this on. Hang on a second. On-off button. There it is. So by default, my flash meter is always set to flash, which is the little lightning bolt. But I can move it across to the sun. I can't do that backwards, hang on. There we go. And now it becomes just a standard light meter. So the idea with these is you would then put your ISO and your shutter speed in. So my ISO is 200, my shutter speed, let's call it 1/25th, why not? And if I pop this here, press the test button, I would get the correct exposure as being F5. So if I dial that into my camera, ISO 200, 1/125th of a second, F5, the correct exposure, and I can already tell you before I press the shutter, it works. All right, okay, so that is, according to the flash meter, the correct exposure. So there's no reason why you can't do that, but of course with cameras, we've got quite a complex metering system, but more importantly, I actually don't look at the meter with continuous light. I'm looking at the image. Well, this is going to be impossible to do backwards. Imagine there's a picture over there. I'm looking at the back of the camera. Forget that, that's really hard to do. I'm looking at the camera and the histogram that I've got in the viewfinder, and when it feels right, it is right. But here's the catch. If you're ever asked to do a live demo, let me just turn that out of the way a second, here we go. If you're ever asked to do a live demo photography-wise, you look at this screen, but no one else does. Everybody else will look at whatever you're tethered to at the other end. So Freya, if you put the other screen on, that's what you're seeing, but that's not what I'm seeing. My screen looks different. In fact, I've got several screens in here. They all look slightly different. But on a trade show, you've got one screen. Always make your pictures look right on their screen, even if they look wrong on yours. Otherwise, you'll spend your whole time saying, but it looks okay on my screen. Yeah, I know. Usually by day two, we've got the screens right. That's usually a day one problem. By day two, it's kind of fixed. Where were we? Oh yeah, okay, put a light on.
So Michael asked, how does it work with the smoke machine you tested last week?
Oh, that's a good question. Hang on a second, Michael, let me just do that. We're gonna get to that, but we're gonna get to the smoke machine towards the end. Can you guess why? That's a good reason for why. So I'm gonna have a second light that I don't have at the moment. I'm going to pick it up when I get to the show. So I'll have two of these, I think it's SL or SZ. I'm not quite sure which ones I'm going to get when I get to the show. Also part of the fun. But I'll have two of these lights. Now I've only got one to test because that's what you get. And I've had it for quite a few weeks, so I've given it a good test. So temporarily, I'm going to use my trusty NAND light, the Forza 60C, because it's the closest thing I've got to what I'm going to be using. I've got it in a reflector. The reflector actually comes with the Godox light, and the reflector is highly efficient. Let me show you how efficient. We know the exposure because I did a light meter reading. So I don't have to change it, still the same. Okay, that's how efficient. That is one very focused beam of light for a reflector. I mean, normally they kind of drift off at the edges quite quickly, but that is surprisingly crisp.
So Mark asked, are Gavin's lights visible from the ISS?
Are they visible from the what, sorry?
ISS.
Oh, hey. I mean,
they look bright on camera, but they're not as bright in real life.
They look bright on camera, but they don't look that bright.
Yeah, in reality. We had this discussion, actually, before we went live, and we couldn't decide whether we should sort of dial down the exposure a little bit so you can see less me. And I think that probably makes sense at this point, just to... So I'm a little bit more silhouetted, but these aren't quite so blown out. I mean, do you prefer that? Let me know in the comments. Is that better or do you prefer it the other way? It's a good question for lives. Don't know. That's why we do these tests. Okay.
Also.
Yeah, also.
Also, John's put, hello from Wisconsin. Hi, John. Where the cheddar is better.
Ooh.
Is it? Is the cheddar better? I mean, is the cheddar not better from cheddar?
I mean, yeah, maybe.
I'd need to taste it.
I'll tell you where the cheddar is best, mm-hmm. On a pizza.
That could be true, yeah. Yeah, just a chunk of cheddar though. You know, I'd have to try the cheddar from Wisconsin just to make sure.
I've tried the Gorge at Cheddar. Cheddar Gorge is great. We used to go there a lot when I was a kid. All the time. All right, so that's kind of fun. We can play around with this. That's going to... Ask Polly just to turn to the side a little bit, turn into the light for me, Polly, thank you very much. Maybe just step back from the light, something like this. I've got to make sure I don't step out of my zone. And if I want to make it a little bit softer, I think I can probably do that without the reflector. So if I take the reflector off, and move it in a bit closer, that should soften up the edges, I think. Yeah, that's going to definitely soften up the edges. Ta-da, there we are, that works all right, doesn't it? Okay, so reflectors just allow you to control the spread, and when they're super efficient like that one is, that's quite nice, I quite like that. I'm not sure I'd want to use it every time, but it is something nice to have access to. But, where's my phone? Okay, just turn that off, and I'm going to launch my app. Hang on. Where is it? Oh, okay, here we go. So all of these lights have got apps. I'm actually going to run the Nanlite app because that's the hardest one to control. The Godox has got much bigger, more older eye friendly, should we say, controls on the back. The Nanlite is definitely better with an app. So I'm going to do it that way around. Bear with me. Yeah. Oh, it's off. I think I've connected. So, yeah, I have. Okay, let's change that to a colour. Anyone have a preference of colour? What colour would you like? I can have anything you fancy in there. What colour would you like? Stick it in the comments. Whilst I'm changing things around a little bit. Let's pop it in the middle for now. You're about 10 seconds behind me in the real world. Or am I 10 seconds in front of you? I can never work it out. Oh, hang on. I'll adjust my lights.
They've started to come in. So
already?
Got, wow. Yeah, we got blue.
If anyone says pink with spots.
Yellow.
Go on.
Blue. Deep purple. Rainbow. There's always
there
one.
There we go. There's always one.
Purple. Green.
Freya, are you putting blue in comments just for purple the whole time?
What can I say? I asked for purple. And
blue.
I was told any colour, pick a colour, and I will say it never seems to be the right colour.
Deep purple,
don't
pink,
pick that colour.
Pink.
Purple, but not purple.
All right, so there's a degree. Okay, let's do purple. Okay, so I'm thinking that might work all right. I'm also thinking maybe a little bit more edgy with the lighting. So let's push it back slightly. You can't get really edgy lighting with this. Particularly with a trade show environment where I've got other lights to compete with. Unlike flash, where I could make this really dark, I have to accept some light is going to reach parts of your model that you wouldn't necessarily choose. And you either get upset about it or you live with it and make it work. I'm going to get upset about it. Okay.
You've got a question from Simon saying, what autofocus do you use?
Yep, good question, Simon. So I'm using the new OM system, OM 1 Mark II at the trade show. So they've sent me one of these to use. So I'm using Face and Eye Detect. Hang on. Let's see. That's the wrong way around. Okay. How's that? Does that work? I'm using that focusing system. Okay. One thing I've noticed is they've taken away the ability to choose left and right eye, which is a bit annoying, OM system. That's a bit cheeky. You used to be able to choose which eye. Now it's eyes. So.
I would like to say that Mark is coming to my defense and saying, let me have purple. And call it my birthday present.
Oh, okay.
Nice, easy birthday present, right?
I mean, that makes sense. It's coming up. We can arrange that for sure.
Yeah. Won't put you out too much.
Oh, yeah, it'll be fine. Okay, so blues and bits and pieces like that. I kind of like that. That's all right. Let's see. I'm also thinking, I don't know, let me know what you think, but I'm thinking maybe we should put some colour on, well, Polly today. So let's see. If I'm going to put some colour on Polly, what am I going to do? Well, there's a couple of ways I could do this with colour. I could make it sort of similar. So sometimes when you're doing colour, colours that are close to each other but slightly different work well. This is where having lights from the same supplier would be super useful because I could have one app and choose the colours.
Simon suggested orange. Because of the compliment.
Okay. Hang on, just having a little bit of technical failure with the camera. The new camera is, oh, there we are, doing odd things. That's new cameras for you. Orange. So, yeah, I think, Simon, you're right. Orange is a good choice, but where would you put the orange? You can have the orange in the background, or you can have it on the subject. And normally, I like to put the orange on my subject. I usually find that as a better option, or at least on their face. Should we put it that way? It tends to feel less weird, but sometimes weird is good. What are we going to do, that one? So let's try and find a bit of orange in here. Okay. So earlier I said there was a bit of an issue with the RGB part of this light. So it's 150 watts of power, except when you're using the RGB bit, it feels about two-thirds of a stop less powerful. So nearly half the power. I guess that would make sense because of how these things are designed, with individual colors blending together to make white. If you only use one or two colors to make a different color, it's never going to be as bright. But that's worth bearing in mind. I think it's closer to about a 60 watt output in RGB, not based on anything other than a feeling.
That looks orange to our eye, but actually on video, it's almost completely white.
So yes, I mean, yeah. So it is
orange, everyone.
So this brings me back to one of my favorite bugbears. It's not which way up is the Union Jack. That's the other one. It is. Don't get me started on that. Upside down, honestly. It is colour. What colour is snow? Oh, snow is white. No, that's not a colour. That's a brightness value. Okay, so white is not an actual colour. Black is not an actual colour. Any colour can be white. It's just an overexposure of the colour. Don't get me started. You had to bring it up. I'm blaming Sam. Okay, there we go. Little bit of orange. So this light is on full power. The background light is, I think, probably on full power. Yes, it is. So the only way I can make that any brighter is to adjust either my ISO, my aperture, or my shutter speed. And I think looking at this, it's going to be the ISO. All of them are going to have an impact with the ambient light as well. And this is one of the things you find. There's some things you can practice, but some other things you can't really figure out until you get to a trade show and you find the lighting is different to what you're hoping for. So if we have a look at this, the lighting here is mine. The lighting in the background is mine, but this is the ambient room light. I don't think it's a problem though. I quite like it. So maybe you want to adjust the hue of that backlight. Oops. There we go. So rather than it being quite so blue, I'm going to try and make it a little bit more sort of greeny blue.
Have you said what your white balance is?
Oh yeah, that's a good point. Actually, I don't know what my white balance is. I haven't even checked. It's set to 5000K is what my white balance is set to. And somewhere I ended up on aperture priority mode. That would explain a thing or two. That's better. Oh, okay, there we go. You know when things aren't quite the way they should be, and you can't quite put your finger on it. Okay. There we go, that's better. Okay, so we can mix those colours around and play around with that. I think I can do better on the day, but for purposes of demos, I think that will be okay. But there's better stuff to be done. So let's move on.
Michael said this looks like a Daft Punk album cover.
It's getting a bit like that, isn't it? Freya said it was Kylie Minogue. Can't get you out of my head.
And another Michael asked, is the colour choice by eye or can you set by a value number?
All right, good. You can. So every app that I've used, another Michael, has an app like this. So you can, this is going to be that light. Oh, you get it, that one over there anyway. So I can choose to have different colours coming in just by touching the screen here. So you can also take photos of things and choose the color if you want to match an object. There's a whole bunch of different ways you can interact with these things. You can do it on the back of the lights as well, but you can't beat these. I'll probably just turn that down. There we go.
So we've had a couple of comments about the way you've got the strip box. So Simon said the sun visor on Polly would look so much cooler with the strip box in horizontal orientation. Okay.
Good point.
And then Michael said he agrees with that, with a grid.
With a grid? Said,
yeah, the grid would look great in reflection.
So there's a reason I'm not using a grid. And it's down to what I've also got on the inside. Actually, have I got this one? Yeah, let me just grab this for you. Let me show you. That is a good, good point. Hang on. Just take this apart. Okay. Okie dokie. Right. Here we go. So, inside of here, we can make that a bit brighter again now. That's worse. The other way. Okay, inside of here is usually two diffusing layers. So you have an outer diffuser and you have an... Oh, I haven't taken it off. An inner diffuser. I've left it on. Let's get rid of that. So I'm going to take the inner diffuser off. Oh, that's good. I'm so glad you asked. That's really good. Obviously stuck it back on again at some point. All right, there we are. That goes over there. Marvellous. So usually when I'm using LED lighting, I will dispose of the inner diffuser and just use the outer diffuser. The light's going to hot spot slightly more in the middle, but really in the real world, it's not that much. And for the same reason, I'm not going to use a grid, because anything that reduces the amount of light when you're already pushing the lights to their limits is a bit of a problem. Now, to caveat that, if I could turn out these room lights, I mean, I can turn out these room lights, but I can't do it at the actual venue, then that's another story. That would definitely be a perfectly okay choice because I could up my ISO. But if I up my ISO and I'm at a venue, then the room lights become that much brighter as well. So there are things you need to consider when you're practicing for a shoot. Things like that. Where are you going to be? What's the lighting going to be? Are you in control of the lighting? And although I'd love them to turn the lights off, I get a bit annoyed about that and they won't do it. Okay, let's turn that back on again. Hey, okay. Did anyone mind about the lightness? Or did we get any comments at all about lightness or darkness of the image?
I think someone said it was a little bit better when it was a bit darker.
Right, okay. That someone is winning. One comment. That's all it takes to sway you, isn't it? I'm so easily swayed. Okay, so this also works when you have a model who can actually move their head. Polly is a little bit kind of, she can't really look up and down very well.
Libby said hi. Hi, Libby.
Hi, Libby. Hey.
Hi, Libby.
There we go. Where were we? Okay. Yeah, you're probably right. I think I'll consider that and make that part of the demo. I don't know which sunglasses Chloe's going to be wearing on the day, but they're probably going to be wraparound. And the reason I'm going to put Chloe in glasses, but imagine this, you're a model that's going to be doing this for maybe an hour and a half, maybe 2 hours, four times during a four-day session. It becomes a little bit straining on the eyes. And although we'll do some with some sunglasses off and some with on, it's just more comfortable. And what do you get? Do you get better photographs from someone who is comfortable or from someone who's going, I really don't want to look at that light again? So you've got to factor that into the equation as well. You know, if you're just doing a half an hour shoot, then fine. But if you're doing a long 4 day session, be kind.
You had a couple of comments saying you need to add a ball head onto the stand for Polly.
I mean, it's getting more complicated by the day, isn't it?
Yeah.
All right, okay. How are we doing? Half an hour, blimey, that was protracted. Okay, so that was supposed to be the quick bit. I've only got a half an hour demo. Oh, no, is it 45 minutes? Maybe it's 45. I'm thinking we're going to throw some light into it and then backlight the scene, but go back to the previous picture for a... Okay, that's backlit, but you can't really see that it's backlit. So I've thrown up a bit of fabric. And I'm going to adjust the fabric. Well, let's take one before and after. Okay. Let's see what we can get here. Yeah, that's going to work. So this is like a semi-translucent fabric. It's like almost like a mesh or a net. And it has a slight shine. Maybe I'll take a different camera with me. How many times have I done that?
Is that what the rug's for?
It's not the first time I've dropped it on the floor. Ah, dear. Right. So I was going to say, go back to the photo. There you go. It's a little bit kind of straight liney. My theory is that I'm going to grab a bit of a peg and clip this at a bit of an angle. Now, we had this working earlier, and I bet it won't do anything now. Let's have a look. Yep, doing absolutely nothing. Because that's what happens when you go live. So I was thinking, if I randomise the weave of the fabric, and what should happen is I randomise that kind of scatter of light. Oh, maybe it is. Let's try that.
There's a couple of comments about your camera.
Does anyone think it's not going to work?
Simon said, OMG, if I pulled my camera down by the tether cable, my heart would fall out of my backside.
Yeah. Honestly.
That was Simon. So Michael, is your demo on lighting or the durability of that camera?
Yeah. Honestly, the first time, yeah. The second time, yeah. yeah, I know. It's a tool for a job. If it breaks, well. That's also, I mean, I did that on purpose to explain that when you do a live demo, in my camera bag is always a second camera because, you know. Okay, these things happen. Where were we? We're going to get a little bit of flare in there. So I kind of like this. I think this gives a little bit of an extra, there we go, a little bit more of sort of a flare going on. Maybe we want to do that. Let's just try getting that closer. Yeah, I quite like this. This is going to work.
You have a travel question.
A travel question?
A travel
yes.
question from I'm Colin. Traveling. How are you going to get up to the show, given that the M25 is closed at the weekend?
Yeah, it's a good point. And it's closed right where we are as well, which is really annoying. So for those that aren't in the UK, the main London orbital motorway freeway is shut for 3 days, which is unheard of. And it's causing chaos and it hasn't happened yet. So I'm going up Friday afternoon. I've got to be there on the day before. Another one of the joys of being a speaker is you've got to be there early to make sure everything is set up. So I'm also the first talk on the first day. So I'll be there super early. Okay, that's pretty good. Trying to stay within bounds of my little area here. Let's just change that light. Yes, okay, we can make some colour. What colour do we want? I'm going to put it on purple, Freya, right? Just for you. I'm going to put it on purple, but anybody else have a preference on colour?
Every time it's purple for one photo, and that's it. The purple goes so quick.
That's, you know, that's life, isn't it? Life is full of rapidly disappearing purples.
You give
you
us, you take
an
us
Instagram
away.
Instagram post.
And Stephen's looked it up, you have 45 minutes spots on Pixapro stand.
There you go, 45 minutes. So that's not strictly true. I have got 45 minutes, but at the end of my demos, I always like to leave something for everybody to come and have a go at, because also standing around for 45 minutes is kind of tough. So if you're coming, bring your cameras, because there will be a photo set up at the end. None of these.
It's a view, right?
It's yeah, selfies. You can get free selfies.
So you've had some answers for colour.
Oh, good, good.
Teal, red. Teal. And red. And yellow.
What's teal? Sort of greeny blue?
Greeny blue.
Yeah.
Aquamarine, bright. Aquamarine, bright green. I'm just
struggling with teal, so come on.
purple.
Oh, you guys are so funny. You think you're hilarious, don't you? No, I've done purple. I'll beat you to it.
Yeah, I've had my one photo.
I did two. They were the same photo, just to check it was in focus. All right, I'm thinking, here's my thoughts. Feel free to tell me I'm wrong. I'm thinking orange. I'm thinking really...
You're wrong.
Or it is, it is wrong. I know, I think it's wrong. But I'm going to do orange. I wonder if there's a brightness here. Hang on, where's the... that's maximum brightness. Okay. Let's see. Should frame it up a little bit different as well. So I'm just thinking maybe orange kind of looks kind of cool. Sort of like that flamey effect. I'm hoping that I can set the light up rather to do something like this so it can sort of cycle through different colours. So I've set this to be a sort of warmish tone of cycle colour. There we are. And let's just adjust my
Dean said he can't wait for all those shouting out colours over the weekend. Are you going to be there, Dean?
He can't speak.
He's really quiet.
Honestly, you sounded like you were waiting for an answer.
No, it did feel like that.
Come on, Dean, shout up, speak up. Yeah, if you're going to come, if you are coming along to a trade show, this isn't going to be held up by a light stand. This is going to be held up by people. Voice-activated light stands of many kinds will be employed at various times. I like to get the audience involved. I think it's only fair. If you come all this way, let's get you doing something. Get yourself in there.
Dean is there Saturday and Monday. Well, I hope you enjoy.
So you're going to miss Sunday. Oh, wow. Sunday is normally the quietest day. It's really weird. You'd think it would be busy. Just avoid Tuesday, student day, is kind of fun day. Okay, there we are. What do you reckon to that? That's all right, isn't it? I think that's going to work. No, just me. Maybe it's just me. Again, I can't hear anyone. And don't get to see the comments. All right, how we got? We got 5 minutes. Should we do a bit of smoke? Let's do a bit of smoke. Okay, well, we'll leave that running. Let's get the smoke machine going.
So Andrew has said there's 187 watching and only 18 likes. So,
I think that's about right, actually, isn't it? There's not. There's about 18 people watching and 187 who are kind of like, well, it's on, but it's on mute.
So, yeah, go and click the like button would be great. And thanks for all your comments. This is brilliant. And here he goes with his smoke machine. So we're not going to see anything there.
It's like the tennis commentary, isn't it? Oop, here he goes, up and under. It's smoke machine. Sam will be doing the commentary on the entire stand. So
this is why I'm not allowed to go.
So if you were here last week, then great. Your Tuesday afternoon is supposed to be quite quiet. So thank you for joining me again. But you'd have seen this, Smoke Machine, Smoke Bee. And I believe, as far as I understand, we've got permission to use it. I've got to go up on Friday and give it a test just to make sure it doesn't set off all the smoke alarms at the NEC. I think we'll be okay. So let's put a little bit of smoke in. Let's turn this on. There we go. That's plenty. Plenty. Stop. Blimey. I will definitely have someone to assist me with this because the amount of time it's going to take me to do this is kind of crazy. Oh, I like the fact I've got it on the random colour generator. How cool does that look though? Ignore the big softbox off to the side. That looks okay. I'm happy with that. This smoke it just doesn't disappear. It's still going. If this was my usual smoke machine, it would have gone ages ago. Okay, that looks kind of cool, doesn't it? Happy with that. Right, okay, let's switch this out. And we'll unplug that. Yep, let's just unplug it. Okay, got any questions? This is a good time to get them in because I'm going to change this over as fast as I can.
So there's one about the smoke machine.
Yes.
If Rain asked, where did you get that smoke machine? Did you put the link in the comments?
I didn't put it. If you go back to my old video, I didn't put a link to everything. Mm. Back to my video from last week, then I put a link to Adorama if you're UK based, or Essential Photo, Pixapro if you're, no, other way around. Adorama if you're US based, or Essential Photo, these are live. Pixapro if you're UK based, and everywhere else, then Amazon will happily provide you one. So it's a company called LensGo. As it sounds, lens go, all one word. And that is the Smoke B. I believe they do a smaller version as well. I don't know, what is it? Smoke A, maybe? S for small?
I thought, B for big? I thought people were saying they had an S version last week.
Okay, well that makes sense.
Might be wrong,
sense.
But it's on the previous live that we did last week.
It's already a bit smoky in here, isn't it? So, amongst the many things I've asked for this trade show is a bunch of tube lights, which I used last time I did a trade show demo for them. I don't have them, so I'm going to use my own, which are these, which are also from Nanlite. These are the Pavo Tube 30Xs. They're about twice the power of the ones I'm going to be using, so I've got them down to 50%. They're also about twice the price, which I suppose is reasonable. Let's just grab a couple of things. And once again, I am not going to be using light stands for this. I'm going to be using human light stands, because that's going to be way more fun. And nothing could possibly go wrong. I've not cleared any of this with the stand, so, you know, that's the plan. Subject to them going, you're going to do what now? Okay, something like that. Shall I turn them on? Oh, wait a second. On, off, on. Hey, look at that. That's pretty good. So, let's turn that off. So, let's see if we can connect up to those.
There's a comment, isn't a question, from Martin. I don't have a question, but I just want to say that you are an amazing teacher.
Oh, thank you, Martin.
Martin.
No, no, I'm Martin. 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 No, I'm thanking. So, I'm thanking Martin, and also Martin. What was it? Martin. Martin. Martin and I go back way back. I've always called him Martin, so that's fine. Sorry. Okay, may have just ruined my credibility with Martin there. Sorry. Okay. So let's turn that one on. We'll turn this one on. Yay! Look at that. Pretty good. So Polly goes in there. So my plan is, my thought is, and again, feel free to tell me this is a crazy idea and no one's going to have a go, but I'm hoping that I can do something like that. I know I'm going to have to bring a light round. And I think this is going to fit into the small space quite well. I've been told I've got a grey background, so this is kind of fairly realistic to what I think I'm going to be doing. Chloe will be slightly taller than Polly. Something like that. Okay. So, yeah, that works all right. That looks pretty good. Not too bad. I reckon we can probably adjust my exposure a little bit. I'm slightly adrift. Let's look at the histogram. There's so much white in this, my histogram is really hard to figure out.
So there's a question about the things that you take to the show from Joe. When you travel, do you take the light stands with you or do you request them?
Wherever possible, Joe, I request the light stands. I will always put one in the car. There'll be one spare. I try and pack spare stuff just in case, but I'd much rather things like light stands. They make a difference, but they're not the biggest thing that I'm going to need to make the biggest difference. And C stands are heavy. So if they're coming with a truck full of stuff to their trade show and I'm representing a brand, I will ask them to bring C stands. Having said that, if they haven't got them, I'll bring my own, but I'd rather not. Okay, this is a little different. Well, this works. So if we don't have access to smoke, this is kind of my plan B. I'm not allowed to use smoke. This is a black mist filter, and it just puts that sort of glow, halation, something like that, around any light sources. So I think that's kind of nice. That's pretty good. And just to finish off, let's put some colours in the background. Any preference on the colours? I've got two now. What would you want? Two colours. Give me two colours. If you're watching the recording, give me the colours. Why not? See if you can guess which colours they're going to be. Somebody wanted rainbow, didn't they? I wonder if I can actually do a rainbow.
You go purple. Purple.
Hang on. So yeah. You keep shouting them out.
I'm just going to read all the purples. Purple and blue.
Purple. I hadn't thought of purple.
Neon pink and aqua blue. Red and blue. Green and red.
Multicolour.
Blue and red. Very Blade Runner.
Blue and red. Yeah, I like the sound of that.
Purple and teal. Teal and orange.
Right. Purple. Hang on. It's decided not to do anything.
That purple looks suspiciously green.
It does, doesn't it? There's definitely a bit of a green tinge to my purple. Oh, there we go. That's purple. And purple and green is what you wanted, wasn't it? Was it? Didn't I hear purple and green?
What is that? Incredible Hulk colours.
You don't like my purple and green? I think that's...
Oh, Monsters, Inc. Mm. Oh, no, it's blue. It's blue. Oh, no, yeah. That's Randall.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Well, this one's decided to totally lose... This is the trouble with apps. Occasionally, they stop working because, you know, it's like miles away, isn't it? Purple and whatever colour it comes back on as. Green. Yes, I knew you were going to do that. Hang on. I'm determined to do it now. This has become like a personal challenge. Forget the fact we're live. That doesn't really matter. That's irrelevant.
Okay, the comments are all talking about Hulk anyway. So, incredible Hoey. kudos for the Hulk knowledge.
I'll go green.
Yeah. Purple shorts, green skin. Yeah.
right. I'm back in control. Here we go. Purple. Right. And then that's two purples.
So someone with some app knowledge.
Yes.
Simon there said, force close the app.
Yeah.
Gavin, they do this.
Yeah, I just twitched the units off and on. I guess that's pretty much the same thing. And then it went through the reconnecting process. Here we go. Right. Burma. So this is purple and its nearest complementary colour. What do we think? I think one's enough, isn't it? Do I need to do any more than that? That's one, isn't it? That's fine. I'm thinking we might be able to kind of do some angles as well. This is where having real people would make life a little bit easier. Here we go. Hey, now we're doing the 80s. I'm sure I had a poster like this on my wall. Kind of looks cool, doesn't it? What do we think to that? So purple and purple. I took more than one. Are you all right now, Frey? Are we happy with that?
Just about.
Just about. I will send you some more from the show floor.
Michael said an X would look great.
Wouldn't it? Yeah. Yeah, that would need a bit of spinning around. And I was thinking about that, Michael, and I think that's something I'm going to ask people to actually do. So my plan is one person either side holding the tubes, and then they can kind of adjust them and make X's and... equal signs, and that's about it really, isn't it? That's the plan. Let's try. Somebody said red and blue. I quite like that idea. Red. That's not very red. Oh look, I've actually got presets on the side. I've just noticed. just noticed the presets. Okay, that's the red one. That's the lower one. Let's make that one blue. Something like that. Ooh, that is red and blue. That is intensely red and blue. That's probably better. Okay, let's try that. Okay. So there's a nice kind of glow where they join together with the colours. Ooh. Now Sam will criticise me if I don't get that absolutely parallel. Okay.
No comment.
The other thing to bear in mind is you can ask your model to turn, you can turn yourself. There we go. So, should we put some smoke in the scene? Should we do it? Let's smoke it up to end up with. So, if you've got any questions, this is your last chance because I was going to finish about 20 minutes ago. So, smoke machine. If you've not seen it before, it's a two-part thing. There is a smoke machine that you can attach various attachments to. I'm just going to go with the standard fan, which, can you hear that? Yeah, it's a little fan that will blow up. I mean, that doesn't actually sound right. I mean, it'll blow up. you know what I meant. If I don't have the fan on, oh, I've got to turn the thing off. It powered itself off for safety reasons. Little button on the side, one and only button, does one thing. Double click and it'll start producing smoke. Okay, and then if you have that, oh. Okay, that was probably a bad idea. Now I just realized what I've done. You might have to use that camera. There you go. But you can see this is a wonderful smoke. It really is nice. That's because it's so thick, and in a trade show where I'm going to be, there's a lot more air movement, then I think that's going to really make a difference. Oh, don't fall over. Grab my camera. Take off the filter. I don't need the filter. Too many things. Okay, that's okay. It is drifting a little bit. I might need a smoke wrangler on the day.
That looks cool though. with the light coming through.
Okay. I think it is, yeah, I quite like it. What I really like, can you see where the blue and the red are merging? I'm getting purple. I mean, I don't know why I'm so surprised. It's like, well, yes. What else would you expect?
Biggie said that it reminds me of the Mission Impossible in the series when the tapes would self-destruct.
Yes, I can see where you're coming from. It does a bit. That's as close as we can get to the lights. And I'm still within my zone. I think this could work quite well. Should we just put a load of smoke in? Let's finish off loads of smoke. Nice and thick. There we go. Oh, it never goes where you want it to go, smoke. Look at that, that is so annoying. And also want to turn that on. Whoa, smoke. Yeah, that's pretty good. So the light stands in the middle aren't going to be there. Another reason I'm going to get actual real people to hold this. I don't know, what do you think? Do you think this is worth it as a live demo? Now, on the unlikely event you're actually coming along to the show and watching this, do let me know. Do come up and say if you saw the practice session. And there's a really nice little thing. If you saw the practice session, can you tell me that it's better on the day? Because it will be better on the day. These are why we do rehearsals, which is pretty good. All right, got one last thing to do. One last thing to do. What do we do? What do we do when we're testing things and we're really testing for real? I will always do one last shot, and I'll do it just for you. Just because you made it this far into the live stream. Now, don't take this personally, Polly, but you're not the best model in... Actually, you are the best model in the house today, probably. Actually, no, both Sam and Freya have been better models.
I was going to say, should we just walk off set?
Shall I rephrase that as best person in front of the camera to model? Yeah, no, I think I've already made it too bad. It's already too late. Okay. We'll just turn off the smoke machine, otherwise you'll be wondering what that really weird sound is. So, I'm going to put this into self-timer mode. I can hear you tutting behind the camera. Honestly, these are the bits I do on every single shoot that no one ever sees. Because you know, it's kind of...
Don't
essential.
Put that dress on again though, will you? It took too long to take it off last time.
There you go. I've got a 12-second self-timer. I'm regretting. Oh, there he goes. Being a new camera, I haven't set up my custom self-timer and I'm not doing it. Oh, honestly, I missed. Don't look at that, that's awful. Okay, let's try that once again. Uh-oh. Oh, I need some sunglasses. That's what I need. What do we got? What do we got? Sunglasses. Nothing like the sound of rustling bags off screen. What do you think? Pretty cool? Pretty cool. So, let's try that once again. Okay. I can't see what I'm doing. You're right. But let's not dwell on that. It's over there somewhere. Okay, I got this. Okay, how's that? If that doesn't come in, if I've pulled the cable out. Oh, I have pulled the damn USB cable out. How did I do that? Well. Okay, let's try that again. Oh, what? Oh. Unbelievable. And that's never happened before. That's the first time I've ever done that. I mean, that's two mistakes in one day, dropping the camera and pulling the USB cable out unexpectedly. Oh, I haven't flipped the screen round. Oh my God, this is awful.
Amateur hour, yeah?
Can we take this out in the edit? Okay, and I've got to stop smiling. Stop smiling. All right, okay. Is that it? Okay, what it needs is some smoke. It needs some smoke. I'm sure everyone's typing it in the comments. I can't see, it's really dark. I really don't want to trip over and pull the camera over. One thing, dropping it from a small ledge. Wait, another. My tripod.
If only someone had a really big light. Like a really bright really light. Yeah, that would help.
Well, what I can tell you for sure is if I was Chloe, I'd be quite appreciative of this. Okay. Oh, well, that's not too bad. One last go. One last go. Here we go. 12. Yeah. 11.
Stuart's
10.
Put no pressure, Gavin. Only 175 people watching you right now.
Okay. Instant replay. Okay, that's all right. Yeah. That'll do. That's actually not too bad. A little bit of cloning out to do. As I say, these won't be here on the final version. But look at that. I mean, ignoring the guy with the dodgy beard. That's all right. That's going to work. Now, I don't think I'll be able to set this up as the final image because I don't think I'll be able to use the smoke that much for 20 minutes. I think I'm limited to about 3. I think it's the total they've given me, which is plenty of time, as long as only one person's having a go. Right, there we go. So that's it. That is some of the ideas I've got for the photography show. I'll read back through your comments afterwards and get your opinions on them. I'm hoping you've come up with some useful, meaningful, helpful advice. Have they, Sam? Is that what happened?
Oh, totally. Yeah. I think what we took from that is purple.
Purple is the new blue.
Something like that, yeah. Thanks for watching, everybody, and thank you for all your comments, and I hope you enjoy the show.
All right, I'm going to say thank you to Frey as well.
Yeah.
So thank you to Frey on the Super Switcher. Give it up to Frey.
Woo! Thanks, everyone.
Sam on the comments. Now you can do your bit.
Thank you, everyone.
Yeah, and thank you very much for joining me again on another completely random live stream. Great fun to do. There won't be one next week because I will be at the photography show. If you're going to come along, there is a link in the video description to the photography show and discount code. If you're a professional, you can sign up and get in for free. You've got 2 days left. If you're an amateur, you can get 20% off with the code at the bottom. I'll be there for all 4 days. Come and say hi. I really would appreciate seeing you. And that brings me to the end of the live stream. So I'm Gavin Hoey. Thanks for watching.